Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I am the RPG Chick. We are in Silent Lys, if I pronounce it correctly. Oh, this leads back to where we were. We came through here. Okay.
No problem.
Right, we were here. Killed that thing. Alright, let's see. Okay, we haven't gone in here. And where was the area with the, hold on. Can't remember, we burst through some kind of wall. Was it here? This is where we came in, isn't it? This is the entrance. Alright. We will run back.
Never know I'm here.
That's the general idea. Okay, so apparently the only place we haven't gone is in here. And that looks trappish or something. That looks dangerous. Oh! Enemy spotted. Any more enemies? I really like the sneak function. There's another room here, or chamber. Oh! There's the mama. Wait. Famished! Ah! We've been spotted! Okay, so... hold up. Yeah, let's cast it on Kalisha. Kalisha will... I don't know if we can cast a knockdown on the spider, so just hit the thing. Try to get rid of this one quickly. And he'll do the same.
Eh?
Okay, that didn't really do anything because she's not actually running up and hitting it.
Mm-hmm.
Wait. Is this game having me switch weapon sets? Because I swear. Yeah, that was wasted. Hit the stupid thing. Sheesh. A spear spider leg. Spear spiders have long, tapering front limbs ending in a sharp point, which they use to impale their prey. This leg is covered in small, backward-facing barbs. Yeah, sounds nasty. Just the kind of thing we should carry with us, right?
I'll be quiet.
Wait, what's this? Bats as large as chickens are strung in this web.
Eh?
Eh?
Sure.
Ew, web sack. So we've got a rapier in here, and a bloodstone. Bloodstone is traditionally a dark stone, often a deep green. But the presence of pockets of iron or red jasper resembling blood spatter give the stone its name, as well as its value. 25 copper pieces. So I guess that's the unit of currency that this is, copper. Copper pieces. Are we ever going to have anything more than copper pieces? I don't know what that icon represents. Does that mean we're leaving? Is that like exit? Let's go this way before we do that. A helm. Okay. Where'd the helm go? I don't like it covering all her pretty hair though, don't you? How about put on Kalisha for now? I know, I'm so vain. I'm so vain with hair. I find it hard to identify things here. So she has scale armor. Scale armor. Hide armor. Oh, it's still on her. Give it to this girl. I thought I'd moved it. Helmets come in many forms, from the humble padded cap to fully enclosed steel great helms. Different cultures tend toward different styles of helmets, but outside of regimented armies, the type of helmet an individual wears often comes down to personal preference. Okay. Well, is this any... Does this offer any protection? I guess not. I guess this kind is just for, you know, just for decorative purposes. Oh, what's this? Oh, an urn with a jasper. Jasper is found in the wild as a dull mottled stone, frequently in red or green, but often with a variety of colors lent by other surrounding minerals. While relatively easy to find, polished, the stone's distinctive swirls of color give it endless variety. And an agate. Agates are common on Eora, oft used by craftsmen for their bright colors. Their considerable hardness also lends them a variety of more practical applications. Okay, done. Wait, this is what I wanted. Okay, I guess we're out of here. Still sneaking just in case, because I'm not sure what this is. I guess this is exit. I guess this is a mountain, a cave. So we're entering the cave or exiting one. Might affects all damage and healing done by the character and their fortitude defense. Okay. New map discovered. Still silent less. Something over there. Oh. Older robed man. By the way, guys, this is probably going to be the slowest and possibly longest let's play of this game out there, so you're already on episode 5. If you're not frustrated by now, I read everything and I go slowly and I try to explore everything and I try to do all the quests and explore every conceivable area. So, yeah, could possibly be the longest let's play. That's the way I do it. It's probably a lot of my let's plays. Anyway, Four figures stand before an otherworldly apparatus, an ancient structure of chiseled adra and metallic veins, ominous and looming like a silent observer. Standing motionless in their midst is what appears to be a human body, colorless as stone or ash. The other figures gaze upon it in what might be contemplation. From your vantage point, you are well obscured from their view. I love the storytelling of this game, guys. The figure closest to the machine stands out among them. A thick gray beard frames a face otherwise hidden beneath a metallic mask. His faded robes are embroidered with a runic language unlike anything you have ever seen, and he wears a strange black headdress with two protrusions that jut out like the wings of some malevolent creature.
Oathbinder, bear witness, and see this man has kept his word true to his last breath, full to his blood's last drop. Guide his soul, queen that was, and regard it among your favor. Let his life by the key be his confession. Let his death by the key be his absolution. May he walk the world ever free of the crushing weight of the book.
Okay. So is this person apparently passed on, and this is some kind of rite, some kind of funeral rite or something like that?
Your brother has done his part, and you have seen the power of his contribution. I will accept no further hesitation from the rest of you. In the sight of the queen that was, will you fulfill the oath? Will you take your place beside your brother in the endless esteem of her memory that is without flaw? Step forth. And be assured of the great worth of your life's course.
The man passes his gaze over the others standing around him. He looks each in the eye in turn. So what the hell is he gonna petrify them to? What the hell is this thing? Oh wow. Their very essences are going into this thing, apparently. Whoa. For an instant, the apparatus goes quiet and the air is still. Then, all at once, it erupts with a concussive surge. Light floods your vision, and you are knocked to the ground. Your head snaps back as you land, and pain wells into the back of your skull, washing your last thoughts away into the black, unconscious void. Huh. We were transported with this thing? You open your eyes to a different place, another time. You stand in a circular room, grand and domed, its walls lined with adra and trimmed with copper. The style is ancient, but the chamber is unweathered. At the far end, a great pillar of adra pierces the floor from below, its shimmering texture giving the illusion of boundless depth. Encircling the pillar is an apparatus much like the one you have just seen, but immense and multifaceted and intertwined. Your thoughts are yours and not yours, and they seem to exist before you think them, and they are all questions. Pressing questions. Troubling questions. Questions that must be answered, or... At the base of the pillar now, you see a man with a thick gray beard and ceremonial robe, crowned with a strange ornamental headdress. You know this man. You are walking towards him now at a pace that is unhurried while trying not to appear so. You have something you want to ask him, one question above all, and the question spins madly in your mind. And now we're back to the present. Oh, we got knocked over. You awaken to find your malaise has broken, only to be replaced with something far more concerning. Faint whispers are audible at the edge of your hearing, like a ringing in your ears that does not subside. Movement flits through your periphery, but when you turn to look, you can see no sign of whatever it was. You find your gaze regularly darting this way and that, an involuntary, paranoid tick. If this is a sickness, it may be dangerous to go without treatment for long. Wow. The figures at the machine stand frozen in place, flesh and blood replaced by cinders and ash. The man who led them is nowhere to be seen. Hiodan and Kalisha lie bloody on the uneven cobbles, their bodies twisted unnaturally in death. They're dead? My friends, I've just met them. You are alone and far from help. Gilded Veil may be your best hope of receiving treatment before things get worse. You just killed my friends, you bastard game. We've advanced a level. Is that your way of making it up to me?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's level up. How do we level up? Click the icon on their portrait. Okay. This? Or that? Click the icon on their portrait. What am I missing here? The icon on their portrait.
Yeah.
Oh, I have major fatigue and I'm messed up here. I didn't know that little thing that was there. That's the portrait. So click the icon. All right, not getting it, guys.
Yeah.
Well, I want to level up, but...
Sure.
Yeah. Can I put any of this stuff... Hold on a second. Can I put this stuff in here? Look at that. I like the metal sounds. I guess that we don't get encumbered in this game. I mean, I don't mind not having encumbrance, it makes things easier. But, it is a little...
Won't get far like this.
Are you encumbered now? Where would it show that encumbrance? Still walking fine. Doesn't appear to be suffering any penalties from that, in any way. I wonder if I can... Oh, if I hold down shift. Is it going in? Yes. Cool. So I've got everything. Now I just figure out how to level up. It's ridiculous. Sorry, I hit the mic there. I'm gonna be right back, guys, because I want to level up. So I'm gonna figure out how to do that. Character. Okay. Oh, neat. I haven't been in the screen. Skulder Whelp. Most powerful enemy defeated. Pretty neat. Times knocked out, damage taken, hits. Show your reputation. So these scolders must be pretty hard to fight. Must be pretty tough. After surviving an explosion outside the ruins of Silent Lys, I experienced a vision. Since then, I've been hearing sounds with no source and seeing things that aren't there. This is not the illness that struck me at the wagon. This is something new. An affliction of the mind, perhaps. With luck, someone in Gilded Vale will know what to do. Oh ho, look at that. Scolders are large mammalian creatures that dwell in caves in total or near total darkness. As a result, they have poor vision and rely on their sense of hearing to navigate and find prey. The protrusions and hairs on their ears allow them to detect airflow, which is key to telling direction in an underground environment. They communicate through screeches and clicks and use these vocalizations in a form of echolocation. They are communal creatures and will nest and raise young together. So I have no idea about any of this stuff, but somehow I found that out. Spear Spider. Due to Spear Spider's speed, say that five times fast, and unique method of attack, very brave or very foolish swordsmen and women, particularly members of the Fangs, have traditionally fought them for sparring practice. Today, this tradition is hardly followed by any but the most rustic and ragged hunters in training. Sorry, warriors in training. The Spear Spider is known, also known as one of the boldest arachnid hunters, as it tends to rely less on its webs and more on its barbed legs to capture prey. As a result, this species ventures further from its nest than most other spiders. Same as spiderling. Wolf. Where there are deer, wolves will soon follow. This Adarian proverb, often spoken with the first phrase emitted, wolves will still follow then, suggests the vulnerability that early settlers often felt in the Eastern Reach. It also speaks to the long association that the Adarians, literally people of the deer, have had with the four-legged predators that are as ubiquitous in the deerwood as they are in the Adarian Empire. Wolves are legendary for their speed as well as their ability to knock their prey prone, subsequently subjecting them to devastating attacks. It was a Zorup. That thing's weird. Some kind of lizard creature, huh? So whenever I meet a new creature, I can come in here. Zorups are reptilian humanoids about the size of Orlans. They adorn themselves with the bones of fallen enemies, mostly Zorups from rival tribes. They also have an affinity for large feathers, which they hang and pin to their attire. Zorup skin tones can vary from light green to a rustic brown. Their elongated snouts, which make speech impossible, and overly aggressive behavior have hindered them from communicating with the more civilized races of the world. They live in secluded tribal territories and are known for ruthlessly attacking anyone foolish enough to cross their path. Zorups revere dragons as deities and build their communities around the lair. There's dragons in this game? Awesome. And build their communities around the lairs of these powerful creatures. It is not uncommon for a small tribe to wander nomadically until it has found a drake or dragon to worship. Once a tribe dedicates itself to a dragon, they will defend it at all costs. Elaborate rituals in which the dragon consumes Zorup's sacrifices are a normal practice. As a dragon grows in age and size, these sacrifices become large religious events that cost the lives of hundreds of Zorups. The power and prestige of a Zorup tribe directly correlates with the age of its dragon. The most powerful tribes have existed for hundreds, if not thousands, of years. Warriors and shamans of these tribes typically paint their bodies to resemble their draconic gods. Oh, wow, you can look up all this stuff. So yeah, this is the complete glossary here. Tips. You can read that. Tombstone icons have personalized messages that may break the fourth wall, so players desiring complete immersion may wish to avoid clicking them. Ah. We've read this in the 1.5 episode. Equipment. Deities. We've seen some of the deities. Huh. I might want to make another separate episode going over this stuff. Some of this stuff. Create new. So that's the journal. Spooky, huh? Oh, the plus sign here. I barely see it. Cool. Skills allow your character to perform specialized actions like scouting, detecting traps, picking locks, or reading scrolls. They can also be used to overcome obstacles in conversations and scripted interactions. Skills will advance as your characters gain level, but items and other bonuses can also increase skills. Okay. So I have 6 points left. Definitely one in stealth. Oh, to get to the next rank, so... Okay. Well, let's go rank 3 here. Athletics. I'm not gonna read all this. Counters fatigue. Take a rank. Lore is used to activate scrolls. Higher lore values allow the character to use higher level scrolls. Miscellaneous knowledge and trivia. Mechanics. Traps and locks. Oh, you can place your own traps. Nice. Mechanics can be used to activate or disable a variety of machines. Mechanics. Let's take one. And survival. Allows characters to make better use of the food and potion items they find. The longer the duration, the higher the skill. Survival can mostly be used in conversations, blah blah blah. This all seems some pretty important stuff. I have another point left. I can't advance more. Points to advance one. And I have another. I guess. Yeah, I need another. Okay, never mind. Oh, I can take more powers. Well, yeah, no powers. What about this one? Well, I'll take one this time. Eye strike. Tenuous grasp. Kind of like that. Range. So I guess the target is one person. It's not area of effect. And whisper of treason. Now when you charm, a charmed target fights on behalf of the enemy at reduced capacity. Speed, accuracy, and all defenses are reduced by 25. The character can only have one charmed affliction at a time. A newer one will dispel any older one present. Okay, I like this. I wonder how long it lasts. Seconds versus will. Okay, let's try that. Talents. So a lot of stuff here. Did I choose a talent when I made this character? Because I might have not even seen these tabs here. Will defense. Weapon and shield. Remaining zero? Wait a second. So I can only choose one. It stinks. Passive. Stuns an enemy whenever they target the cipher's will defense. How often will that happen, though? I don't know, man. Let's take greater focus. It's going to help with a lot of things. Ta-da. Okay. So we leveled up and our friends are dead. Good news and bad news. Well, thanks for watching. Stay tuned next time when we, well, we're obviously heading out on our own here. And we have to cure our affliction. And we have to explore the land and not die. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And I don't know. I don't like my new sign off that much. So I'm just going to say bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.